Hello, it is Coyote Entertainment here, and we are here with another podcast. I'm here today joined by Scope, Bread, and Mook.
Hello.
Hello.
Today we're going to have a lot of fun.
All right, let's begin. And today the topics are going to be Black Ops Beta, because that came out. Well, the codes have come out for Xbox One, and we actually did a giveaway. Scope did a giveaway, and that went well, and he just received one death threat. That's about it. But today we're going to be talking about Black Ops. We're going to be talking about, what else are we going to be talking about? We're going to talk about the new Metal Gear Solid trailer, the launch trailer that Kojima made, because that was actually really, really amazing. We're going to talk about YouTube gaming. Haven't messed with that at all, but I've seen a few videos on people covering it, reviewing it, like Boogie and another YouTuber. What's his name? I'll link him down in the description once I look through the history. But we're going to be talking about that, and then we're going to be talking about a bit of Fallout, like always. And yeah, and then we're going to talk about our week and, you know, what's happened this week and how excited we are for Tuesday, because that's when Metal Gear Solid comes out. And we're going to have a lot of fun playing it. All right. So, Black Ops Beta, it's really fun to play. It kind of looks like Titanfall in a sense, but it has that Black Ops feel. And you're able to wall run, you got a jet, you don't got a mech. But that's fine, because it's Black Ops. And from right here, we have Mike doing some customization on the weapons, putting some, it looks like, just cosmetic features on it, like blue paint. It's pretty cool what you can do right now. But yeah, Scope is actually the only one here that's actually got a chance to play the beta. I haven't really played it at all, so he'll be the one mostly talking about it.
I've played two rounds on Mike's Scope's account, and I actually pretty much butchered his KD ratio, but I think he forgave me.
It's fun. The only thing I have to say is that it's really hard for me to put it in words, because I like it. It feels like Black Ops with a more a twist to it, because I didn't really like Advanced Warfare's exosuits shit that much, and it feels like that, but not as obnoxious in a sense. And it definitely has mechanics from Titanfall, that's undeniable. All in all though, I was kind of hoping for character customization, and I hope that's in it, and I hope that these specialists, which, you know, they determine, like, they each have their own, like, a special ability that they can do. Like, one guy can teleport back to his last known location in case he's in danger. Someone else can take two giant metal spikes and stab the ground or get faster boosting, you know. Someone can have an armor lock shield. I like it. It's cool. I just wanted more of, like, a personal character customization, because I also heard in the story for Black Ops 3 that they'll be doing, you're the main soldier. You're the main character. No Mason, no anything like that. You are the main character. So I think that's really cool. But, I mean, all in all, it's not a bad game. You know, if you've liked Call of Duty before, you'll like this one. I mean, it's kind of hard to not if you like Call of Duty. I mean, the only one I can say that really didn't, for some reason, live up to its standards was Ghosts, but,
Modern Warfare 3, I did not like. I'm sorry. Couldn't get, like, past the first mission.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, that too. I mean, if you have $5, I mean, I'm done with the giveaway, and it went pretty well, I guess. Once again, congratulations to those who won. Blaze Blake, please email us or Facebook or something, because we have to give you your code. Or if you don't claim it soon, we do have to give it away to someone else. And then, you know, we'll have to randomly pick everyone again. So I would say at least by tomorrow, just email us or something, get in contact with us, even in the YouTube comments, just let us know you're there. Then we'll figure it out. But if you don't pick it up soon, we do have to give it away. So we don't want to do that because that would be horrible, you know. But yeah, the beta all in all, it's pretty fun. I won't be getting it immediately. I say that with every Call of Duty, but then I end up doing that. But yeah, there's, if you, like I said, you like Call of Duty, you'll like this one. If you like Black Ops 2, I think you will like this one, but it's a, it's almost not a different, but it's like a fresh change, different change of pace. So yeah.
Now, I was thinking, like, when you said that you were hoping for, like, a more, like, character-based customization, what if they do it like it's, like, you know how in a Battlefront, how you get a certain number of kills in a row, you unlock a hero? What if, like, these people that you're playing as are the heroes, but they just kind of throw them to you in the beta as, like, hey, here's what you can have, here's all the fun that you can have with them, and here's how chaotic it can be, like, with every ability, every character being used, and it just gives you that, like, feel of tension that everyone has something different and they can all use it to their own, like, I don't know how to put it, but I guess to say, like, originally you unlock them as a, I guess, kill streak bonus, like you can play as a certain character, get that certain ability for the team, but I'm not exactly sure on how that works. I haven't really looked too much into Black Ops 3.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting. That actually kind of, that'd make a lot of sense. And that would also further the point that character customization will be a thing, hopefully. Because that'd be really cool. Be more immersive to, and really refresh the shooter itself by just making your own character. You kind of feel like you're in there a little bit more. And again, to me, I know a lot of people say, like, Call of Duty is overrated, it's rehash and all that stuff, but it's a chaotic, it's fun. It's fun to shoot people just running around, and it's just a lot of, it's just not made to be taken seriously or anything. At least that's what I get from it. It's just a shooter that you can play online. It's very user-friendly, anyone can literally get into it and play it, and that's what it's for, and I really like what they're doing here. It looks a lot of fun. They're taking a lot of ideas from Titanfall and putting it into this, and Advanced Warfare as well. And but the only thing I've seen so far that I haven't really, you know, liked was that input lag. You know, the kill cam show? You kind of, like, you're shooting up a guy, and then he kills you, and then you get this kill cam, and it's, like, a complete bullshit, just showing the inputs completely wrong, like, you weren't shooting this guy all of a sudden, and, yeah, I want to avoid that. Or at least I hope they fix that, or if that's just a beta thing. But, yeah, that's just the only feature I don't really like so far.
Speaking of kill cam, I saw this pretty intense kill cam that is actually an opportunity because of the new mechanics that they have. Like, for example, the wall running. There was two people running on a wall, and they were actually ended up running towards each other. And while they're running on the wall, one of them just shot, shot, shot. And then you got the other guy right in the head. And it was a pretty intense moment. So I'm pretty interested, I'm pretty interested to see what kind of new tech-ish type stuff that they bring into this game, what kind of cool kill cams you are able to see, you know, minus the input lag.
Yeah, but yeah. How long is this beta available? I think it's available till Sunday, right?
August 30th.
Yeah. August 30th, yeah, being, yeah, Sunday. So you get to play it till Sunday, which is really cool. So I don't know if your level is going to transfer with you to Black Ops 3, but I don't know. I kind of hope it doesn't. Just because of that would put everyone that has played the beta in a total advantage against the people who have to wait until they can get the game or wait until a later time to pre-order the game. But yeah, Black Ops 3 beta, go check it out if you have the money for it. It's literally just go up to a GameStop, put $5 into the pre-order, give it a try. If you don't like it, take it out, and there you go. No. It's not a hard loss, but, and there's a lot of people doing beta code giveaways because there's just so many codes to give away. So, check it out. It's Call of Duty, so you already know the deal. Alright, so we're gonna move on to our next topic, being Kojima put in his final trailer, which is the launch trailer, and it just going through the years of just Metal Gear in general, and like it's gone through a lot of games. It didn't cover Portable Ops, which was weird. I don't know if it's considered canon or not, but it went through Peace Walker 3, went through Metal Gear Solid 1, 2, all those, and it showed a scene, which I think is, again, a lot of people are like believing that Skullface is actually Snake, but and this trailer just kind of like, you know, moved that theory up for people, but I don't think that's the case. I don't think Kojima would give us a major spoiler like that. It kind of looks more like a reflection of what Big Boss is becoming. He's becoming Skullface, and let's say, because you know, they foreshadowed and they've shown in the trailers that Skullface has been, you know, working or talking to Big Boss in some scenes. So that could mean anything towards them working together, or they becoming comrades at some point, or maybe it's one is fooling the other. Because in the end, I'm pretty sure by the time Big Boss leaves wakes up after his coma and leaves the hospital and all that, he should already know that the unit coming after him being Skullface's unit, and XOF, and who Skullface is. So I don't think the whole BB being Big Boss is real. I think Skullface is an actual character that will actually flesh out, and maybe he'll have a lot of he'll be that kind of antagonist where he has a lot of things to say that you can actually agree upon, which is one of the better evils out there. And after that scene, we got a scene and we got to see the new Metal Gear. Very, very, very Peace Walker like inspired, very Zone of the Enders inspired, with the whole cockpit literally being a cockpit. And it's like and it has this whip sword, which in the E3 2015 trailer we saw Snake running driving away and dodging these giant spikes chasing him. So now we know what is causing that spike, and that technology, that the whip sword, was the same thing they showed in the Mother Base gameplay, the wormhole. So that led me to the theory that I think, and also at the end of the trailer you see little Eli, you see him coming out to Mother Base with the rest of the gang pretty much. So that leads me to believe that Metal Gear, you eventually take it for yourself. You take that thing for yourself, and maybe, just maybe, we'll get a reward. Because you know, in Peace Walker, you created Metal Gear Zeke. You created that, and you put lots of time into it just for Paz to kind of take it from you. Just for Paz to, yeah, just take it from you and use it against you. So you didn't get to use it. But I think in this one, we'll be able to use that Metal Gear, play it on the field or something. That would be really awesome and a really good send-off to the series.
What if you think possibly, after you defeat it, if you do defeat it in this big boss battle, like you have to fight it and defeat it first before you make it your own? Afterwards, the way you take it to Mother Base is you just full-ton it up.
Wow, that would be use the wormhole Fulton to bring it out. But yeah, also one thing to note on that trailer: if you go back, you can actually see when it's rising up to show you the full kind of like profile of how tall that Metal Gear is. You can see young Mantis for like
floating
above it for like just a frame or so. But I think that has to do with maybe Eli can't control the Metal Gear all the way, and I think it's young Mantis that's helping it out, helping it move out and do all that stuff.
Or what I was originally thinking, after I noticed young Mantis floating there in the, well, literally above him, I noticed that what if the Metal Gear itself has, like, the whip sword, but young Mantis is what causes the spikes. He's the one who basically powers the Metal Gear. It's so large that they haven't necessarily devised something that can like sustain it for so long, so they have young Mantis supply it.
Yeah, that's actually really interesting, and that could be an actual thing, but yeah, that trailer was... That was, oh, sorry, let me just... That RCXD looked really weird going, the way it floated around. But yeah, there's a lot of awesome, juicy details, and showing the Metal Gear, although I wanted it to be a surprise, but oh man, seeing that full thing in action was terrifying. And that sound that it makes, that it has, I guess, when it slams down, it was pretty awesome. And I gotta say, that trailer is a good way to make the game even more hyped than it already is, with the reviews that leaked in early. Well, not even leaked in, the reviews that are coming in early, and it's getting like tens across the board. So you know that game is going to be worth every cent you pay for it, and you're gonna love every part of it, or maybe not, who knows, depends on what kind of game. But from what everyone said, it's your game, and it's how you play it. However you play it is the way you'll enjoy this game, and that's the way you're, as a player, are the one who's making everything. You make every choice. It's not a scripted thing. Like, you'll be getting chased, and you'll, like, let's say you jump onto D-Horse to escape, or you call, like, the chopper, and you jump off a building into the chopper. That's all you. That's not a cutscene. That's you as the player creating these scenarios to escape. And I think that's what I like the most about The Phantom Pain. It's pretty much Peace Walker 2. And
open world. Open world Peace Walker.
Yep, pretty much. And, man. Tuesday's going to be a great day for gamers.
Wait, wasn't there, didn't they already say something about you can customize boss? Like, you can customize them, like, visually?
Oh yeah, that was a spoiler. Like, that was saying that I don't know if you can customize Big Boss himself, but there's someone that you can customize early in the game, which is kind of weird. I guess that might be maybe for online purposes. Maybe when, like, Metal Gear Online comes out next month, that character will transfer, or maybe it's a story plot. I don't know, but it's something weird. To keep you kind of like, I guess, thinking. Yeah, something to look for and something to keep you like wondering what's going on. And yeah, just, it's been a really, really good week, really slow week, mainly because, you know, when a game you've been waiting for is right.
Literally a week away, it's right around the corner, Tuesday morning.
Right around the corner, it's just right there, but. You know, you have to wait for it, and it's not Tuesday, and that's all I'm thinking about. All day I'm just thinking about Metal Gear, watching Metal Gear, everything about it. And that's what I'm waiting for, so I've been watching Yong stuff, anything else, trailer stuff. Anything that could keep me, you know, filled with Metal Gear. And I've been playing Peace Walker too, so if you ever want to play Peace Walker, I'll put my PSN account down. Well, my username, you guys add me, I'll play Peace Walker. I'll play that anytime, but I don't know. Well, I don't know if I'm going to be playing it when MGS comes out, but definitely add me on PSN, and we can play MGS 5, and you can raid my mother base all you want, get my resources, but I'm going to fight back. So anyone have anything to say about MGS this time around?
Friendly UAV inbound. I'm just really excited for it. That's all I'm gonna say. The only problem that I see that I might be having is the fact that me and Scope share an Xbox One, so we're gonna have to like take shifts and have a schedule or something.
Yeah, it's definitely a game that you literally have to invest a lot of time into, micromanaging that mother base, and splitting it sounds like it's gonna be quite the ordeal. But yeah, hopefully you guys find your balance and don't get too overtaken by the game, you know. Always remember that there's always someone else that wants to play it as well. But yeah.
I feel like we're eventually going to be invading each other's mother base in real life just to see who gets to play.
Oh, all right.
You're going to invade each other's house and play on their consoles.
That's one way to do it. So, One question for Scope. How's your experience right now?
With what? The Black Ops 3 meta, or...?
Yeah, this match right now.
Well, I'm honestly, I'm feeling a bit under the weather, so I apologize if I'm eating shit, but I'm trying my best here. I'm having fun, though. I guess that's all that counts, but, you know, some people may disagree that I'm not pro enough, I guess, but, you know, whatever, whatever. But, as MGS comes along, that was a headshot, I pre-ordered mine today, my copy, and, I'm pretty excited, because, I was hyped, but I wasn't, like, oh, Metal Gear, you know, until I started playing, Ground Zeroes a little bit, and once I started playing that, I was absolutely fucking hooked shit. And, basically, like, I started reading more into it, you know, later on I want to play Snake Eater because that seems the most interesting to me. Even though I've heard it's a bit of an eyesore, it still seems pretty cool to me. But yeah, Phantom Pain, I've looked so much into it, and it just feels like such a good game. And you got me killed. And then so, and where was I? Such a good game. I just like all the little things you can do in it, like, you know, micromanage, that's a pretty fun thing. I actually like games that you can do that in. And as subtle as it seems like a really huge part of it. Definitely gonna do some base invading with, either some friends or any of the fans who want their base invaded and who wants to get wrecked, hit me up on Facebook or Twitter or on the comments, and I'll gladly give you a shout-out. But I'm not gonna hold back or anything like that, you know. It's all about the fun. I'm going to probably, my tactic is, not really killing anybody, get fucking wrecked, boy. I'm not really into, oh god. Oh, there it is. Not really into killing in Metal Gear Solid. I'm actually looking forward to full-taunting the hell out of everything, because I really want to build the best base ever. And all I'm gonna do if I invade any bases, I'm just gonna probably take everything with me. I'm going to avoid you at all costs and just and full-taunt everything you have, so that when it comes to that point, you know, then I'll kill you. But, you know, I'm gonna make sure I take everything from you before I kill you, because that's what it's all about. It's about, you know, sharing. Sharing is caring. But most importantly, you know, I played Sniper Elite 3, and honestly, each mission in that game is like, has to be an hour or something like that, because it comes with planning and all that shit. And I haven't played a game like that since, Sniper Elite 3, and then I played, Ground Zeroes, and a lot of people said it was too short, but if you sit there and you actually plan tactics out, it could take you quite some time. I mean, yeah, it lowered my rank. I think I got like a D the very first time I played, but that's because I actually just sat in Omega Base and, just literally, I don't know, I explored, checked out all the neat little findings, cassette tapes, I got all this, was it Fox patches or Zoff patches? Zoff, okay. I got all those patches, you know, and then after I did Ground Zeroes, they give you a bunch of other missions. It's really in-depth, and like Geo said, it's worth investing the time to, just like, you know, it can quickly, like, anyone who's never played the game, if you play Ground Zeroes and at least just give it a shot, you'll definitely like it, you know? You just play each and every mission. They have one, they have like all different kinds. Yes, they're all on the same map, but it's almost like a chance to show you how the daytime cycle is. Like, oh, now it's going to be in daytime, so now they can see you easier. Oh, it's nighttime and it's raining. It's going to be a little bit harder to see you, but they have spotlights. It's different little things that are cool, you know? I'm actually excited for Phantom Pain and all, and you know, it's I think it can grab anybody and make them become a fan as it did me, so.
Alright, now, as for micromanaging, brings me to the next thing. Fallout. Fallout, building your own base, building your own town, that on its own, knowing the Fallout lore is just that's hype on its own. Comes out November 11th. That's gonna be a good day. That's
strongest survive
between MGS, Fallout, We're going to have a lot of free roam titles this year, this end of the year, this fall.
Mm-hmm. We got, Fallout, we got MGS, we got Just Cause 3, we got Mad Max, we got Xenoblade Chronicles X, we got, what else is coming free roam? We had Arkham, we had the new Arkham game, what else is becoming free roam this year? I think the new...
Ghost Recon.
Yeah, Ghost Recon's becoming free roam. I think the new Hitman is becoming free roam. It's just... Sandbox is taking over. It's the... Pretty much, it's the new shooter of the generation. And that's... That's what... I think that's, like, one of the... Maybe the future of gaming for a while. Kind of like how zombies took over for who knows how long. And we had so many zombie games.
I mean, honestly, I think, to me... I feel as if even modern day shooters like, or futuristic shooters, if you want to call them that, like, Call of Duty, I feel like they're gonna adapt into a free roam kind of thing. Not like, you know, free roam completely, like, you know, you can build up your own character, your own profile, make your own story if you want, and, you know, you progressively play multiplayer matches and all that stuff, but... you know, it's your character you're building up and all that stuff. So I think that'd be cool. So it'd be like, I guess, free roam in a sense. I mean, it's just like how Ghost Recon's doing it. Like, it was always a very linear kind of shooter, but now it's taking a whole new turn on it. And I've always wanted to see Hitman go free roam. I think it's pretty sandbox-ish, I guess, if you want to call it that, because that's, I think it's going to be pretty great, especially how the new way of contracts are going to go. But yeah, it's gonna be pretty great. I think free roam, like Gio said, is the new age. Who knows what's next? Honestly, card games maybe. Who knows?
Free roam card
games.
Yeah,
free roam card games. Who knows? But yeah. What was this? Oh man, I'm blanking hard. Yeah. I just hope that, like, one thing is for certain is that the way the free roaming is going, I hope it continues to go that way, and it doesn't get pushed on with, like, stuff like, you know, microtransactions, like, or locked content, that kind of thing. Because Destiny, to me, was, like, for example, Destiny was advertised as an RPG or free roam, and it really wasn't. It was kind of just like, oh, you know, all right, well, we're gonna put you in this area, and then if you want to go to this area, you have to go through another loading screen, and et cetera, et cetera. So I just hope free roam is the actual key word and they stick to that word.
Oh, let's not forget, also for free roam, they may not be coming out this year. At least I don't think so. There's also Mirror's Edge. There's Crackdown, which is 100% destructible. So they say so far. And if that's the case, that's going to be exciting. An entirely destructible environment, entirely destructible world. That's something to be hype about.
Oh yeah, I heard. Yeah, it's gonna be what, using cloud storage, so it can even use all that extra memory to destroy the city, because I don't think the Xbox One has that much. That's really cool. I hope they stick to that. That's a really nice idea. Having a completely destructible having a completely destructible environment. That'd be nice, and I wonder if anything we build, I hope it does, because then that would suck. It'd be like that one Fallout New Vegas mod with destructible environments, but whenever you break something, it breaks for life. And that could really kind of ruin, well, not ruin, but yeah, ruin, I would say. But yeah, let's see, what we have on the topic is... YouTube gaming is now kind of like, it's almost like Twitch. It's a whole, it's a web page for YouTube, and it has a bunch of, you know, live streamers and gamers just, playing their own games, and it has also videos to Let's Plays and stuff like that. So it's kind of like just a central hub for gaming and, like, everything gaming there. So I guess it's not like it's removing you from YouTube, it's just, it's putting it all at a category, kind of like YouTube Music, stuff like that, or
whatever YouTube uses.
Yeah, whatever YouTube uses as a program. But it, from what I've heard, I've seen that the video quality is top notch. It's really nice. It's really nice. The delay is good. Barely any, like, not too much delay, and it, you can, you know, respond fast and all that stuff. There's a bit of a few problems. I don't know. This is, I don't know if they've fixed it. I need to check in on this, but they have a few problems where you have to change a title of the stream or game you're playing. You have to stop your stream, then write down the thing and stream again, when that could be an easy problem that you can just fix up, and that shouldn't have to, you know, have to take you out of the stream, go back into stream, change the game. It should be just one thing. You just change the title just like that. And they have, I think, yeah, Boogie covered the video, made a cover, you know, covered the video on, I mean, sorry, covered YouTube gaming in a video, sorry about that, and he talked both positively and negative about it. And the only thing I didn't like was the whole, it has the copyright bot going around, so anything, you know, if you slip up once or like use something accidentally you get copyrighted, it can take you down, it can take, it can affect your actual YouTube account, and that's kind of something to fear about.
Yeah, one thing I've noticed with it, it's very hit or miss as opposed to Twitch. Like, they both have their ups and downs, but one thing that they definitely have that that Twitch doesn't is, say you have to go to the bathroom in the middle of a stream, you can actually rewind it, and you'll be like 5 minutes per se behind the stream. You'll be a few minutes behind the stream in case you missed anything. That way, you're still watching it, but it will be basically like watching a YouTube video. And if you need to, you can fast forward to catch up to where everyone else in the world is, or you can just stick to where you're at and stay behind. No matter what, though, it always keeps you in the know. You're never, like, left without, like, oh, what if I didn't see him do this? So, oh, what if he said something that I missed, and I'll never be able to figure that out unless I go back through the comments. Well, now they have a way that you can actually go back, watch it, and it's something simple, but it's very, very helpful, very useful tool.
Yeah, it sounds good. It sounds if they improve it, it could be a good alternative to Twitch. And I think the what he said to get in it, it's like the threshold is a lot easier than Twitch's, which is, I guess that's really good. So it's a lot easier for new Let's Players, streamers, and just overall people that love games and want. Sorry about that. My mic is all weird. Hold on, give me a second. But yeah, just it's coming for everyone. It's gonna help out a lot for new people that want to start, kind of like us. I don't know. I don't really see myself using it. I do want to use Twitch more than anything because I like Twitch. The Twitch community is really nice. The emotes are good, and just it overall, Twitch is just more familiar, and that's really wanted me to keep on Twitch, and I think that's just how it's gonna be for a while. But maybe they'll have some things that will really, really wow us with some exclusive features that they have. But yeah, YouTube gaming is gonna be good when it's all fixed up and everything. And I have some high expectations for it, and I hope it has a good future ahead of it. I mean, anything to help out a fellow YouTuber or a fellow Let's Player, someone that just wants to play games that people don't have access to, that's always good, you know? There's always games you don't have access to, but someone else does, so you can watch them play it and see if you, you can kind of experience yourself, you know, and be immersed in it. And I think that's gonna cover pretty much all the topics we've gone over today. That's all the topics for today. This podcast is actually a pretty good, decent amount of time. And I guess right now we're going to do our little, you know, post get to know us stuff where we just talk about our week and whatnot. This week actually has been, I don't know, it's felt pretty busy. Like, I haven't really been able to work on my video because I went to go see my girlfriend, which was nice. Haven't seen her in a long time, so that's always good. And we were at the mall, so that was really, it was a really, really busy day going around and just kind of walking around. And just, I don't know, malls in general, they just get
very repetitive.
Yeah, very repetitive, and you always have to be, like, really rich, to be honest. You just, I mean, the food court, like, really, they just upped the price for no reason. But yeah, this week has been feeling pretty busy, but but really slow. And that's what, I don't know. I think it's just MGS in general that's keeping this slow, at least in my head. But yeah, my week has been pretty eventful in a sense that I've been out of the house. I took some pictures, which is good. I like to do photography and stuff like that and just go outside and take pictures of nature. And I hope to do more street photography once I go down to the city. That'd be nice, just around the daytime. It sounds really good. And I take a lot of photos and I post them on this Facebook page, so I guess I'll share it in the description if you guys want to check it out, if you guys are into photography. And one thing, if you guys are into photography, please message me, help me out. I love hearing new tips and hints. Just like tips I can learn to use outside and what lenses I should buy, because that's really good. I wanna get more into it, but I'm kind of like, you know, demo kill. I want to say I don't know too much about photography, but I know what I'm doing, I guess. I want to say
general basics.
Yeah, general basics. But yeah, my week's pretty much been all right, not too many crazy stories to say. No insects or roaches this time around, but yeah. Except, okay, there is one insect story, because for some reason there is one every week. I was in the shower, and there was actually a spider in the shower, and it was trying to crawl away, so I'm like, okay, I'm just going to let it crawl away. I'm not going to kill it, because there's no reason to. It's a spider, so it will kill the bugs every now and then. So I was just there taking a shower, and it's trying to climb up the wall, and I guess the wall was wet from the water, so it fell down. I'm like, oh no. So I'm like, I moved the hose a little bit to, you know, away from it so it can get back up and do it, and it couldn't get up. Like, it was, I guess it was like just water weight was all over it, so it couldn't get up. So I felt horrible. I'm here trying to take a shower and there's like a spider down there suffering and not being able to move. So I'm trying really, really hard to help it out. So I like grab the shampoo case and just like I move it.
Scoot it up.
Yeah, I try to scoot it up and he's just not moving. And so he scoots up and he kind of gets back up and he starts climbing again and he falls and then is like, I guess he hit hard or something, because his legs started tangling up. So I tried helping him out again, and I just like, I felt like I was making the problem worse, because he just kept like twitching and just like his legs were knotting up and all this stuff, and it was starting to get really, really horrible. I'm like, why? State restored. Why does this always happen to me? I'm just trying to take a shower and this spider is just dying.
Actually, I know there was a, it was actually last night, there was, I went in there to go, shave, because, you know, I may not, I like to take care of my beard, you know, it's nice, I'm proud of it. And so, I go in there, I'm just, you know, combing it, just making sure, getting ready, and I noticed something in the corner of my eye. So I look, like, I guess I focus in the corner of the mirror, and I noticed something. It's like a little black spot. So I'm like, okay, maybe it's not what I think it is. So I turn around and it wasn't. It was actually a spider. So I'm like, okay, whatever, it's fine. So I turn back around. I'm facing the mirror again. And I hear something above me. I look up, and it is probably about a 1.5-inch roach crawling along the ceiling. And it scared me so much that I just didn't shave. I just went to bed, didn't kill it, and I just, I got sidetracked. It was horrible. I just went inside, played GTA, and just, I gotta have a palate cleanser for this. For this demon that lives in my bathroom. So he's still there, I'm assuming. Just waiting for one of us to be alone. Slowly kill us.
Oh man, roaches are, I swear, the plague of the earth.
Alright, so you guys have roaches and spiders. And my interactions with insects always happen to be something like a bee or a wasp or a fucking scorpion.
Anytime you're on the slide.
Yeah. I was going, we were at a park, a new park that was just built recently about a month ago. And I was like, oh, I'm going to test out this new slide. And we were like, we threw some stuff down it to make sure there's like no spider webs or something like that. And let me tell you, there was not a single goddamn spider web. I started going down. I was going down kind of slowly because I wanted to make sure I wasn't going to run into any little pests. And then next thing I know, there's these three bees just flying above my head. And they're pissed. I don't know. They start coming at me. So I slide down. And I start yelling. And they're like, what's going on? What's going on? And there was just a lot of bees. And then...
actual bees in the slide.
Yeah, friggin' this is a children's slide. Oh my god, and then there was a kid that went up there and they were about to go down the slide. We were like, we don't know if we should warn them or not.
Remember those, while we were there, there was these like, we saw this like, what looked like to be a flying beetle going around scope. And it turns out it wasn't a beetle at all. We went to the bench. Floating around with other things, and it was these big, really huge, like really the size of your thumb, like giant bees. These I don't know, they were wasp or bees or something, but they were terrifying. They were like quarter size, huge. That's when we decided to run away and leave.
Oh, let's not forget, we also have a snake that lives around our house.
Oh yeah, we have a snake that lives around our house. It likes to climb trees, which is pretty cool. And I don't know, I guess if you live in Florida, you notice that every animal just likes kind of like chilling out with people. I don't know, every animal's pretty nice here, but the insects are terrible.
Yeah. Oh.
There's actually a albino squirrel that used to run around my little lawn. You know, go up the trees, this and that. And a long time ago, I thought, wow, that's not very good to be in nature because a lot of predators can see you. And so I thought like a hawk or something was going to catch it. But no, one day I'm out there and I see it getting eaten by a freaking snake. How did a snake catch a squirrel? Those things are fast.
Yeah,
my little albino buddy got eaten, unfortunately. But maybe he passed on his albino seed to other non, or maybe albino squirrels.
That'd be cool. A little just herd of albino squirrels. Herd of squirrels that want to help you out later in life. It's like, hey, remember that time you didn't save our dad? Well, we were going to help you, but you didn't help our dad, so we're going to kill you. And then they decide to just eat you.
Oh, they're gonna eat me. They're gonna unhinge their jaws like a snake and swallow me whole.
Yep. Take revenge.
Real revenge.
But yeah, that's kind of been the week, and I don't know, we're just pretty amped up for the game that's coming up, MGS. But yeah, I think we're gonna have to wrap things up. And I really, really enjoyed this podcast, and I hope you guys did too. And you know how it is, just, you know, like our videos, check out the rest of our stuff. We have other stuff other than podcasts. We have just reviews, discussions, all that stuff.
Skits
even. And we have more coming. We have a lot more coming. This channel is going to be awesome, and I hope you guys stay to watch. And thank you again for all the new subscribers, and hopefully we can do a giveaway again soon. Who knows? But This is Coyote Entertainment, and we're just gonna sign off.
Ah! Ah!